Hi everyone, my name is Harold Mitchell and I'm the lead psychologist for Richmond Public Schools. And today I want to talk for a few minutes about empathy, specifically the differences between empathy versus sympathy. They're easy to confuse, but let's give it a shot. Empathy is feeling the same emotions as the other person, while sympathy is feeling sorrow or concern for the other person. Let's watch a short video from Dr. Brené Brown, a famous social science researcher who discusses the differences between empathy and sympathy, and then we'll talk more about it.
So what is empathy, and why is it very different than sympathy? Empathy fuels connection. Sympathy drives disconnection. Empathy, it's very interesting. Teresa Wiseman is a nursing scholar who studied professions, very diverse professions where empathy is relevant, and came up with four qualities of empathy. Perspective taking, the ability to take the perspective of another person or recognize their perspective as their truth. Staying out of judgment, not easy when you enjoy it as much as most of us do. Recognizing emotion in other people and then communicating that. Empathy is feeling with people. And to me, I always think of empathy as this kind of sacred space where someone's kind of in a deep hole and they shout out from the bottom and they say, I'm stuck, it's dark, I'm overwhelmed. And then we look and we say, hey, you can climb down. I know what it's like down here. And you're not alone. Sympathy is, ooh, it's bad, uh-huh. No, you want a sandwich? Empathy is a choice, and it's a vulnerable choice, because in order to connect with you, I have to connect with something in myself that knows that feeling. Rarely, if ever, does an empathic response begin with at least. And we do it all the time, because you know what? Someone just shared something with us that's incredibly painful, and we're trying to silver lining it. I don't think that's a verb, but I'm using it as one. We're trying to put the silver lining around it. So, I had a miscarriage. Oh, at least you know you can get pregnant. I think my marriage is falling apart. At least you have a marriage. John's getting kicked out of school. At least Sarah is an A student. But one of the things we do sometimes in the face of very difficult conversations is we try to make things better. If I share something with you that's very difficult, I'd rather you say, I don't even know what to say right now. I'm just so glad you told me. Because the truth is, rarely can a response make something better. What makes something better is connection.
Now I want to talk to you guys about empathy blockers, or things that interfere with empathy. The first one is when we downplay the problem, such as, I'm sure it's not that bad, it's not the end of the world, so it's kind of minimizing it. The next one is denial. There's nothing for you to be upset about. Everything's fine. Another empathy blocker is reasoning away the problem, such as, don't get upset, she didn't mean to hurt your feelings. We're trying to cheer somebody up when they're upset before they've really talked about a problem. Don't worry, let me tell you a funny story I heard. We're putting a positive spin on it, such as, look on the bright side, it could have been worse. Or advising somebody, why don't you focus on something else instead of worrying about that? Or having expectations. You should have known better. So it's almost shaming somebody. Or putting someone down. Don't be silly, you're being ridiculous. Or labeling. You're too sensitive. And the last one is stealing someone's thunder. Now you know how I felt when the same thing happened to me. So really bringing it back to yourself instead of listening to the other person. Now I want you guys to decide are the following statements showing empathy or sympathy, and some of them are hard, but let's just go through them together. Empathy or sympathy, from what you're telling me, things must be really hard. What do you think? That's empathy. What if I said to somebody, that's terrible? Would that be empathy or sympathy? Sympathy. What about this one? I know how you feel. I think that would be empathy or sympathy? Good, sympathy. What about this statement? I understand what you're going through. Empathy or sympathy? Sympathy. Because we don't really understand, we have to ask somebody. What about, I think you're saying that life is very difficult now. Am I right? Empathy or sympathy? Good, empathy, because you're asking for clarification. So let's go over a few more differences between empathy and sympathy. Empathy is, I feel how you feel. Sympathy would be something like, I know how you feel. Empathy is no judgment. With sympathy, there's a lot of judgment. Empathy, we just listen. That's what people want most of the time, is just to listen. Sympathy is when we give unasked advice. Empathy is being sensitive to all kinds of nonverbal cues. With sympathy, we overlook subtle signs and only take surface meanings. We may not notice that they look sad. We may not notice what's going on with them. We're just listening to their words. Empathy is, I can understand how it feels. It must be really hard. Sympathy would just be saying something like, poor you. Now what I want to do is show you guys a short video that shows students discussing what empathy means and how important it is for all of us to give and receive.
Empathy is a choice, an opportunity to put yourself in someone else's situation, to view the world through the lens of someone else's circumstances.
Empathy is the ability to think about what someone else is going through, imagining yourself in that place. Empathy is seeing with the eyes of another, listening with the ears of another, and feeling with the heart of another.
Empathy is being there for people who are your closest friends or someone you don't even know.
Empathy takes work. It takes practice. Empathy requires each one of us to stop thinking only of ourselves and to start thinking of others.
In our world, everybody has a need for empathy, whether it is great or small.
Every day, in every school, students are made fun of, outcasted, looked down upon, and made to feel worthless.
Life can be lonely at times. It's important to feel like someone has your back.
We judge people when we do not understand them.
People say sticks and stones may break your bones, but words will never hurt you, as if that were true at all.
Empathy towards others encourages hope, encourages love, or encourages tolerance.
Respect people's feelings. Even if it doesn't mean anything to you, it could mean everything to them.
Empathy shows the people that are hurting that someone cares and that they are not alone.
Instead of putting others in their place, put yourself in their place.
No prescription works like empathy can.
We must step out of our comfort zone and be the reason someone smiles today.
Empathy is like a wildfire. A simple spark can ignite a chain reaction of compassion.
Empathy can change the world. It started with just one person, and that one person could be you.
Well, that's it, everyone. I hope you learned some differences between empathy and sympathy. That's just a quick overview, and it's good to practice because it's hard sometimes to know the differences. Empathy can be hard, but again, I want you guys to practice because it's what all of us need and want, especially from those we love and from the people that are around us. I hope you learned a little bit today about empathy. I've enjoyed being with you. Stay safe, everyone, and know that RPS misses you all, and we hope to see you soon. Take care, everybody.